today. From Raymond James Stadium in Tampa, Florida, it's the NFC Wild Card Round on EA Sports. We'll see Tom Brady and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers taking on Jalen Hurts and the Philadelphia Eagles.
Playoff football has come to the west coast of Florida, and we are at Raymond James Stadium here in Tampa. Straight ahead, it's Wild Card Weekend, and we've got a great one in store between the Philadelphia Eagles and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Hello, everyone. Welcome to the postseason on EA Sports alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden. And Charles, that's really all I need to say to get you fired up. It's the postseason on EA Sports.
And no one's more fired up than the guys who are going to be playing in this game. This is what they fought for all year long. Go back to the OTAs, the mini camps, training camp, throughout the season to get to the playoffs. Intensity level will be off the charts.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Philly's offense getting ready, and Jalen Hurts ready to lead them. The second-round pick who started his career at Alabama, then finished with an electric senior season at Oklahoma.
Let's face it, it doesn't matter if you're a rookie free agent or a 15-year vet. Guiding a team to victory on the road in the playoffs, that's no small feat. And it's going to be really important for him to play mistake-free football. But equally important, create some big plays as well to give his team confidence that they can win.
But first down, Hurts. Open man is Goddard, the tight end. And he's upended at the 33 following a good pickup of 8. Second and 2. A good safe pass there right off the bat.
That's almost a rhythm play. That's what we like to call it. Get them into rhythm early, something safe, something they're confident about, something they feel good. And once that's completed, then you just keep moving from there because the confidence elevates.
And just play number 3 here on the opening drive, and it's an early 3rd and 1. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. Just a 1-yard gain on the play, and that'll mean a call to the punt team as it's 4th down. So opening drive, 3 straight runs, unable to pick up the first.
I know the fans want to see first downs, but guess what? The coaches have reasons for what they're doing. Sometimes they've scripted it, and some of these runs, while they haven't been successful now, they may be successful later on.
And no one there to stop it. Hits at the 8, but it carries all the way into the end zone for a touchback. Tampa Bay coming out along with a man who needs no introduction, the great Tom Brady.
And he comes into this wild card round off of a really good regular season, better than 30 touchdown passes. And he said he feels like he can take some shots against his secondary. In fact, in our meeting, he said not only can he take shots, he expects to do it early.
Brady going to bring the Bucs up with a 1st and 10 at the 20. Brady going to fake the give to Jones and set up to throw. It's caught by Mike Evans. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. A nice grab there for a guy coming off a terrific season, one that saw him have over 100 catches.
And when you have that many catches, that means you're a full part of the offense. And let's face it, he's been as good as anyone in the NFL this year. So figures he's going to play a big role in whether his team can advance in the playoffs.
A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be 2nd down. You often say that sort of opens the playbook now, 2nd and short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
From just shy of midfield, Brady. And that's complete. It's Chris Godwin.
Well, from their point of view, this game could not be starting out much better, could it? Force a punt on defense, and now they're moving it crisply on offense.
Crisply, I like that.
Yeah,
moving it very, very well. Looks like the defense on their heels a little bit. You put a score in here, long way to go, but you're right, that's a heck of a start.
Yeah, and I think this is where the play caller is looking at his play sheet and saying, grab that dagger play, grab that play and just finish them off right now, because I think they'd love to gain that big advantage early.
Someone's looking fresh, and this O-line is definitely licking their chops. Everyone likes to run block if you're an offensive lineman. Nice early burst, nice gain, too.
Second down, back to Fournette. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25.
How best to describe that one? I'd say right down Broadway on that run.
A straight ahead running. I think that that might be something we see a lot of between the tackles today.
Well, he's enjoying things so far here this afternoon. Sees a crease and bursts through it for a solid gain.
Fournette a first down carry, but he'll get only a couple before defenders are there to meet him. We talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
Play number 7 coming on this drive. It's 3rd and inches. And Evans calls it in. Touchdown, Bucks. Evans there to make the grab, and the Bucs will strike first here this wild card matchup. Well, these guys have won 3 straight ball games and another good start to this one out to the 6-0 lead.
And I've talked with so many different coaches, as have you, along the way, and they always talk about winning streaks and the mood of a team and how much easier it is to actually prepare during that time. Guys are sharp, guys are focused, everyone's feeling good, and we're seeing it early in this one.
Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. And Rager will not return it, so it'll come out to the 25 on the touchback. So back onto the field, here come the Eagles for their 2nd drive. They've been a come-from-behind team all year. They'll need to do it again as they trail early in this wild card game. Hurts and the Eagles come up here 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line. They'll start with a handoff to Sanders. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1-yard gain up to the 26.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs. Run some plays, run some clock. Allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
2 runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it. After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports. Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. Into the secondary, past the 40. And Hurts able to show off some of that elusiveness as he slides to the ground there and in the process picks up the first down.
We just saw a nice example of why teams often bring in baseball guys to teach quarterbacks how to slide in key situations. You want to protect your franchise guy, make sure he doesn't get hurt. He did exactly that on that play, a perfect slide to avoid the big hit and pick up a first down.
5 yards on the catch there, brings up 2nd down. Hurts sets up to throw it. He's got Dallas Goedert, his tight end, over the middle. And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs 40. They go back to the ground with Sanders, and he stopped immediately there. It was Jason Pierre-Paul who was able to get him down. So after the run for no gain, here's 2nd and 10. Hurts a handoff to Sanders. And a pretty good run there as he gets 7 down to the 33.
Good running right there. And this is a man who's a 1,000-yard rusher in the regular season, so you know he's going to get his chances. And he picks up nice yardage on that one.
Throwing is Hurts. Open man, that's Devontae Smith. And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs 14.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
And it's complete right back in the hands of Smith. A gain of 6 there on first. Working with his 2nd and 4. Hurts. And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Jalen Hurts taking it in from 7 yards away. And the Eagles are within an extra point of tying this thing up. Good with a PAT, and we are tied here in the 2nd quarter. So the drive goes 75 yards, 10 plays, and in the end it's capped off by a 7-yard run. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And this will be a touchback, so they'll bring it out to the 25. Tampa Bay, they're getting ready to set up shop here for their 2nd drive. After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this offense's sails because they had it going pretty good last time, too.
Had to sit over there for a little while, didn't they? You know, they were eager, amped up to get back on the field after just scoring, hoping to get the ball back quickly. That didn't happen, so I'd say come out, just kind of get started again. You know, it doesn't have to be anything dramatic. Just get moving, get loose again, and see if they can get it downfield.
Second and 10. A handoff to Fournette. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
That 2nd down play call was not to pick up the 1st down. It was to accomplish what they did to get him into a manageable 3rd down because they had incompletion on 1st down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
A reminder coming up at the half, as we've done all year. We'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. Coach will have the lowdown on what's going on here in this wild card weekend as we begin on the road to Super Bowl 53 in Atlanta. Oh, what a catch by Gronkowski. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. A big connection on that one. 37 yards.
Big plays always wind up being a big theme as we get rolling these playoffs, and the defenses that can avoid giving them up. But they're the teams that tend to go far. You may not eliminate those big plays, but if you can limit them, then you've got a chance to get to the ultimate game.
Fournette, a 1st down carry. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, 2nd and 2.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a 1st down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
Fournette once more on 2nd down. And he's going to take this one down to about the 23-yard line. The good run on 1st down followed up by a not-so-good run on 2nd down.
Now let's find out if they're going to stick with the run here on 3rd down. A lot of people would love to see some play action here. I say go with your best running play over your best blocker.
And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this 1st half. Now Jones. He gets this down to the 3, but no further. Brought the power run out of the bag and got a couple extra yards with it. The Bucs going to go ahead and use the 2nd of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 33 seconds to go in the 1st half. So the ball position now at the 3. Here's 2nd and goal. Now Brady. Touchdown! Rob Gronkowski from 3 yards out. And the Bucs have taken the lead.
You get down near the goal line, this is where having a sure-handed tight end becomes a luxury, and it pays off big time, especially when the defense sells out against the run and he finds himself open for an easy touchdown.
Extra point try now for Succop. And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game. So that one, an 8-play drive. It spans 75 yards. And it's all finished off with a touchdown by Tampa Bay. Now Pinion with the kickoff honors following the touchdown. From the 6. And able to get this out to the 25. The Eagles going to get one final possession in this first half. And they've got less than 30 seconds to go here, so not a lot of time to work with. They'll throw on first down with Hurts. And this one too low. He was looking for Miles Sanders out of the backfield. And it's second down. Here's Hurts to throw. Can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. They bring a man off the corner that time, and he gets home for a loss of 6. So we come upon halftime here in this NFC wild card matchup. As we send you a stone's throw away across I-4 to Orlando, there standing by is Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach?
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. This, the second of our triple header here on Wild Card Sunday. We'll get back out to you guys in just a moment. But first, let's take a look back to yesterday's NFC Wild Card game. And you can see the result there. Meanwhile, nothing settled in our Wild Card game. It's a tight one as we get ready for the third quarter. Standing by to take you the rest of the way, let's get it back to Brandon and Charles.
Okay, Coach, yeah, adjustments likely going to play a big role in this third quarter in what's been a tight contest so far. One of these two teams about to play their final half of the season as we're back at it in this NFC wildcard bout. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Out come the Buccaneers. They'll have it first to start the third quarter. And they've been the better of the two teams through two quarters of play, much to the chagrin of this home crowd.
Yeah, this score is a surprise to a lot of folks at home, although not to my dad. He predicted the visitors would win. And maybe to the folks in the stadium. But you know who is not a surprise to, partner? This team with the football. They were very confident coming in.
Six yards on that last play. Here's second and 4. They keep it on the ground. This time it's Fournette. And tackled down after a gain of 3. Leaves him with 1 yard to go on third down. That's some good tackling there to keep him short of that yellow line.
Yeah, defensively, all I'm thinking is that on that play, get me to third down. Get me into a position where I can make one more play and get my defense off the field.
Heavy set out there on third and 1. They'll try and run for it with Jones. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
A run there on first down and a pretty good one of 5 yards, so make it second and 5.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last 4 plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, 4 plays in this drive, all 4 on the ground. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
This is, oh my goodness, he pulled it in one-handed. A big play that time through the air. 33 yards.
It doesn't look like this defense found the magic elixir at halftime. This offense was rolling in the first half, and that's continued here in the third quarter. Another big play right there.
So after the big play, look at this, all the way down at the 15 now on first and 10. Brady gives this one off to Jones. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and 2.
Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this drive, because when you see that type of a run, I get the feeling the defense getting a little bit tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look up at the scoreboard. And he's able to get it down to the 2 yard line.
Well, this has been a long drive. In fact, it's eaten up a good chunk of the third quarter, which is precisely what you want when you're playing with the lead. You control the football. You control the clock.
And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Ronald Jones taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Bucs take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. But just power football there down near the goal line. Give it to him. He's able to push his way across.
Yeah, they went heavy there. Sometimes you have those big offensive linemen come in, have to report like they're eligible. But all they're doing is getting a good stance, blocking, and getting their runner across the goal line.
Extra point up and good by Succop. And it's now 21-7. That time, a 9-play drive. And it's Ronald Jones that polishes it off with a touchdown run. Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. So here are the Eagles now as they get set for their first possession of the second half. And their deficit a little wider than it was at halftime. Does that touchdown a minute ago change the thinking here at all?
I think it does, at least a little bit, because now urgency has to start setting in. You can't go out there and go three and out and run the risk of falling behind substantially, but you have to do it without pressing, because pressing, that'll lead you into bigger errors.
A little bit of space there for the first down run, as that's going to get him about 5 yards.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here, and what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
Can't find a receiver, and he's brought down.
So one quick, easy analysis about why they struggled so far. They keep putting themselves in third and long situations. They just took another sack right there.
And the offensive film session tomorrow may be a little longer than it normally is.
Not a lot of positive grades will be handed out thus far.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. From the gun, it's Hurts. That swung out wide to Sanders. And they're going to get him down well short of the first, as he can only get this to the 30. They do get 7 out of that, but not enough to prevent a fourth down. The Eagles send out their punter now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. With it is Brown. That'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt. And the Bucs will get ready to go on offense. Back now comes Tampa Bay. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? They score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly, because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, you feel like you can take the spirit away from another team, that their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
Still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, they're teetering right there on the brink, aren't they?
And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. One quarter remains in this NFC wild card matchup. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. The Bucs on third down. A perfect 4 for 4 thus far. They're up against a 3rd-and-1 situation. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. 61 yards on the ground for him now on 9 carries.
Brandon, when a defense just simply can't get off the field on third down, and we all know how important that down is for both sides of the ball, you often feel like you're just a step behind whatever they're doing offensively.
And one of the differences in this game, no doubt, third down conversion, and that is going to be a story they'll talk about after this one. And they'll get to him after a gain of 7 to the 47. A good run, got 7 on first. Here's 2nd and 3. Here's a give to Fournette. He'll get 3 up to midfield.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
I think we're seeing the effect that runs like that are starting to have on this game. They're a little bit slower, that front 7, reacting to the football, almost like body blows in boxing, slowing them down, and they're really starting to take over in this game.
He's got it complete to Gronkowski, and he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line.
Well, that should be a reminder defensively, and I think it's a reminder to myself, because you just can't sell out to stop the run. There's still enough time that this offense can move the football through the air, even on 1st and 2nd downs, and they obviously picked the right spot to throw the ball there.
And he'll get about 4 there as he takes it from the 10 down to the 6. The 6-yard line, the line of scrimmage on 2nd and goal. They'll give Fournette another crack. It'll be a gain of 5, and it's going to set up a 3rd and goal.
They're in a pretty good spot right now with a convincing lead. I think this is where they put on the boxing gloves, start to try and pound them into submission.
And the offensive line, they've controlled this game. I don't see why that trend would change. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Leonard Fournette. Excellent work there to get in on the touchdown run. And the Bucs continue to show why it pays to play at home in the postseason as they add on to their lead. But look, this is a team, Charles. They faced adversity all year long. They had to fight and claw to win that division. But they're putting it all together here in the wild card game.
Feels like a statement, doesn't it? An absolute statement game. A message to the top seeds. Overlook us at your own peril. We're pretty darn good.
Extra point put through by Suckup, and the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. A 10-play drive that time. And the man who finished it off with a run into the end zone, Leonard Fournette. Now Pinion with a kickoff honors following the touchdown. Taking it about the 1. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Philadelphia's offense ready to give us another look. They are most likely staring at a cold end to their season here in this wild card round. Nothing has gone right so far. And they are, to be frank, in desperation mode now as they begin with a 1st and 10. They'll try and start this drive in the air. On the move to it, and he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Ndamukong Suh in there to get him. It's a loss of 5.
Okay, was it a breakdown in protection? Did the running back not pick him up? What does it really matter? Sometimes it's just a great play made by the defense. Big time sack.
Another try after the 1st down sack. Hurts rolling to his right, and he'll slide to a halt here, still a little shy of the 1st down marker. So it's Eagle football here as we get your reset. They face a 3rd down now as they try to find a late score. That is caught. It's the tight end Goddard. And he is going to have an Eagles 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. Back to throw here. This is Smith with a grab. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. Goes right back to Smith again. And this winds up a pickup of two, maybe two and a half, to about the 39. From the 39, Hurts. Dancing to his left. Airing it out deep for Smith. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. Of course, they had the option, and they choose to not take the penalty.
They like the results of the play that they just ran, and they elect to let them stand.
First down marker at the 31. It's third down. Again, he'll drop to throw. And that is knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
They'll try and throw for it with Hurts. And a dangerous throw there as that's knocked down and incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And as a result, their playoff run may end right here. So they tried to go for it for pride, but it really wouldn't have mattered. This one, it was already determined.
No doubt about it. This one was over a while ago.
And they'll try and burn some clock with a sneak. And a good swarm to the football defensively as they get him down at about the 40. 2 yards the gain on the keeper, and it's second down. Give him three on the run there. Now they're looking at a third and about five. The Buccaneers are moving on in these playoffs as we say thanks for watching and so long. So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. The Bucs are winners here as we say so long from Tampa.